So I would go home and just be by myself again. But this time I would be home by myself at nighttime. And so I would meditate a lot, or I would read. And I really took that opportunity to educate myself on just anything that interests me. Like, there's articles, there's books, there's anything. I would, if I thought of something, Amazon Prime, that book is coming here, I'll read it tomorrow. Like, and so I would just take in all this information, and I would, I don't know, I just, being left alone and being able to take in the information that I valued, just kind of left me at a spot where I was just like, oh yeah, this is it. It just, things became very clear to me.
Meditation is becoming much more mainstream, but I think it's also very, still very threatening to people. And, you know, honestly, to a lot of people where we come from, still very demasculating. Oh, yeah. It has that stereotype. So what did meditating like that do for you? Cause you was obviously very committed to it.
Well, I still meditate regularly, but I don't meditate at the rate that I was doing before, primarily due to my schedule. I have so much schoolwork that I don't get to meditate for 8 hours a day the way that I was trying to before. So there are a lot of different, from everything that I'd read and everything that, you know, there are lots of different techniques to meditation, and there's a lot of different goals to meditation. Sometimes you're seeking something, you know, this, that. Yeah, there's a lot of different application to it.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of different schools of thought that approach to it. What I did that got me to the place that I was at is I would meditate on nothing. It was more of a, I guess, almost like a more Buddhist approach about trying to get rid of everything. Just, I'm trying to clear this, just make everything go away. Because then once everything's clear, it's almost like trying to clean a room and it's just cluttered and piled, and you can't organize everything if it's in a pile. But if you spread out the room and categorize it and then put it up the way that it's supposed to go, you can put it up way easier once it's categorized. And for me and my ADD brain, it's just too busy. It's too much noise. So meditation really got me to that level space that I needed to get everything put away and in its right cubby and labeled and laminated and air freshener was sprayed. Like, I don't know. I needed just time to be quiet and to be alone and to really get introspective. It wasn't like I was necessarily seeking enlightenment or anything.
Yeah.
But in a way, it kind of inadvertently got me to a point of clarity that I think people are seeking, and I got there without intending to. By no means am I proclaiming enlightenment. That would be foolish. But I do think that I'm far more together because of what I did.
Yeah. But I mean, I think, honestly, having the same disorganized, kind of constantly in rotation, ADD, ADHD mind, it almost is a point of enlightenment when you can find some kind of method that helps you to organize that and to clear that and really just allow you to form a clear and direct pathway to whatever it is that you're trying to do. Mm-hmm. And I really value the discipline that it takes with that, because I also like to meditate and I've tried to meditate, but I have not yet got to the point where I can stick with it and let it clear my mind. Because for me, the act of meditating, I'm not disciplined enough to commit to it, I guess. It's like, I guess I still have trouble clearing my mind. I sit down to meditate and it still feels like a chore rather than a release. And I've not got to that point yet, but I have noticed you have became a very disciplined person. And I imagine that what you found through meditation probably guided you to that as well.
Yes. I got very organized, I guess is the best thing, the simplest way that I can put it. By doing meditation the way that I was doing it for as long as I was doing it. And the way that you talk about how it feels like a chore, it absolutely starts that way. 10,000%. I've never met anybody who has ever meditated for long, like, periods of time, spanning months or years or whatever, that started out and was like, oh yeah, I just started doing it and felt great. Like, it's a slow climb, and it's the first several times is just like, okay. But I think gotcha. The reason that I got there was because of the schedule that I was on, and there was nothing else for me. It's almost like, I don't want to like antiquate it to prison, because I've never been to prison, but I assume the same level of isolation that you get from being in a cell by yourself is the same thing as me being in a place where everybody's asleep and it's dark. Mm-hmm. Like, I can't talk to anybody. Like, Austin, my best friend, he's in on deployment doing whatever overseas. All of my other friends are asleep, or the people that I work with are playing video games. And I, at the time of all of this, I approached the whole situation with the mindset of what is important to me. And up until that period of time, video games are very important to me. Like, I tried to play games competitively, and I was like, I'm gonna do this. This is gonna be my thing. And I got to the point where I was like, this shit doesn't matter. I can enjoy it, and I can enjoy it recreationally, but I need to learn how to do everything that I do in moderation and not in excess, which was something that was very difficult for me up until that point.
Yeah.
So, like, as of now, I have it up in front of me. I have, what's today's date? It has been 821 consecutive days where I have only had water to drink, and it has been 733 consecutive days of being a vegetarian. And I'm not like everybody should be a vegetarian. Uh-huh. Like, I just, I think that it helped me for one, lose weight, because when I was very depressed, I just ate a lot, and I ate a lot of shitty food. Like, when you work at Denso and there's a Burger King right there, you're going to go to Burger King.
Yeah.
So, to like kind of cleanse that out of me. And I was also very concerned for my health, because like, diabetes is a thing in my family. I think it's probably a thing in everybody's family if you're from the South, because it's the South. And so I was like, you know, I don't want to do that. And where's all the sugar coming from? It's probably all the tea that I drink. I should stop drinking tea. And so it started out also, let me get on that. I was drinking so much milk at the time, and I don't know why. I was I just like it. I would be drinking an entire gallon of milk in 2 days. Dang. I would drink that. That's a half gallon a day, Grayson. That's too much milk.
It's a lot of milk.
A whole lot of bullshit. So, and it's expensive. Like, so I was just wasting money. Again, going back to that mindset of, is this important? It's not. I'm going to get it out of here. So I stopped drinking milk. And then I was like, oh, well, if I'm not drinking milk, I should stop drinking Coke. Okay, so now I'm only drinking tea and water. There's so much sugar in tea. I should just drink water. And then that's all I did. So I kind of stair-stepped my way down. And vegetarianism also, like, I just was like, I'm eating so much fried just meat. Because also, like, I hated vegetables. It's like, why? Have you tried them? No. Why haven't you tried them? Well, because you have meat and potatoes, and that's it. Like, I understand that potatoes are vegetable, I understand. But it's not a real vegetable. You know what I mean? It's like, it's just starch.
It's fake vegetable.
Yeah, it's like, that's what you tell people if you're like, I eat vegetables, what, potato? Yeah, get the fuck out of here. Like, just shut up. So I just tried to scale all that back. So it was almost like a mind, body, spirit thing. Like, I was able to clear my mind. I was able to change my diet and really get I got weight off, and I felt better. Like, then that's a thing. Like, I've never been like a fat guy, but I've never been like a fit guy either, you know? Yeah. And when I felt like I lost weight, I was like, oh my God, I have so much energy. Have I just been walking around like this for years?
Mm-hmm.
Like, 'cause when you lose that weight, you're like, holy shit. Like, I'm never tired. I'm never going to sleep. It's fantastic. So I did that. And so that was like getting my mind clear, getting my body clear. And like the spirit just kind of came along with it. Like I was like, oh, I'm just in total tranquility now. Like, how do I not just feel totally fulfilled? How do I not feel like I'm totally at one? Like, I just felt like, whew, it was like, it's almost bizarre. Like, I don't know how to antiquate it to anything other than it almost felt supernatural, where I'm just like, whoa, I feel so like, it was such a polarizing feeling from the way that I had lived up until that era, that I was like, it felt like night and day. That's why I say that it feels like that. It feels so just different.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I was able to get my shit together.
Well, I mean, I think that like self-care is an enlightening experience. Like when you really, first of all, when you listen to yourself, because I think that that's really what you were doing, you know, with meditation, is you were listening to yourself. And as you start to listen to yourself and ask yourself that question, what is necessary and what's not, that's really taking into consideration how to balance your body and your mind. And when you do start doing that self-care and you get to that point where you really feel like you're making progress, it's like it's something you've never experienced before. Mm-hmm. And I think it's really difficult for someone with ADHD because you constantly have so much stuff buzzing around you. But once you get to that point, it really is an enlightening experience. And it's unfortunately, it's very, very hard. I'll speak for myself here. Doing things that make me feel like I'm taking care of myself are hard because a lot of the times they conflict with other things that I want to be doing or that people want me to be doing.
Right. Yeah.
You know, and that's nobody's fault, but it is very hard to stay committed to your own self-development and your own self-care. You know, from, you know, getting up in the morning on time and taking some time before you have to get ready and things to go into the gym after work every day, whatever it is, there's constantly things popping up in your life and constantly other things or other people pulling you in different directions. Mm-hmm. And I think there's something to be said to getting to a certain level of confidence in your own self-care that you can be flexible and know that you can pull yourself back. But it is very difficult to stay committed to like going to the gym on a schedule for myself when I'm getting pulled in this direction to talk on the phone, this direction to play video games, this direction to do that, because all these people are wanting you to do things that you also value and enjoy. So it's a journey, but I think that if you commit to it, it really does change you as a person.